And then the worst president in the history of our country took over. And look what happened to our country. Probably 20 million people. And you know, that's a little bit old, that chart. That chart's a couple of months old. And if you want to really see something that's sad, take a look at what happened.
What's up, guys? So I made another intro for this video, which will play right after this intro, but I had to make a new intro because shit hit the fan, as you've probably heard. There was a shooting at the Trump rally. So stay tuned.
My journey to the Trump rally began in Pittsburgh, but before we get there, let's take stock of what you just saw. So that was me evacuating from the rally with the rest of the crowd. At that point, we didn't know anything. We didn't know if Trump was alive or dead. We didn't know shit. It was total confusion and chaos. But now that some time has passed, lots of information has come to light, so I'll be including what we know so far in this video. I initially intended for this to be a straight-up documentation of a Trump rally. That's it. Obviously, I had no idea it would turn into an assassination attempt. So, now this video will serve to hopefully give you, the viewer, a perspective you may not have seen anywhere else in the media, from the viewpoint of an attendee who just so happened to film everything leading up to the shooting itself, and its aftermath. Also, stick around because I got some really great footage of the Secret Service sniper team in the moments leading up to the shooting, footage that I have not seen anywhere else.
Howdy folks, I just arrived in beautiful Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and today I'm here to go to a Trump rally. Look at this gorgeous room. Can you guys see this? Look at this. My buddy Matt, my good friend Matt, one of my many beautiful subscribers, got me this free room because he travels all the time for work and he gets free rooms. So here I am with this gorgeous view of Pittsburgh. I was gonna sleep in the van tonight. Now I don't have to, especially in this heat wave. That was gonna be a freaking nightmare. So Matt, you know who you are. You're the king, dude.
Here I am driving to Butler, Pennsylvania, which is about 45 minutes north of Pittsburgh, and like I said, had no idea I was about to be in the middle of one of the craziest days in modern American history, but here we go.
So they instructed us to park at the very end of this long road. Hot. This is a long, hot walk.
The first thing I noticed was there was a lot of cars, a lot of people. People love their Trump, they really do.
Of course, I didn't see the actual parking lot, which is this. And this is free. So, stupid me. I knew Trump wouldn't do me dirty like that.
Hit the mag lines. Hit the line. There's some down there that are open. Let's keep moving.
Just went through security, got patted down. Also was handed this free bottle of water. I read there was gonna be free water. Smart, thick, and Trump, it's hot as hell out here.
First thing I noticed walking in, they had plenty of places to go to the bathroom, a whole line of porta potties, and they had real restrooms inside of this building, a ladies' room and a men's room. Like I said, everything was very clean and very well organized. I was pretty impressed. There was also no shortage of places to get something to eat, from burgers to hot dogs to pizza to ice cream. Of course, the lines were long as hell, so I didn't get anything.
No, it's
Listen to this music, man. Even the music is amazing. Titanic. Fuck yeah. Like I said, it was hotter than the pits of hell outside, but they had plenty of indoor areas where you could escape the heat and escape the sun. As a matter of fact, the people who were supposed to be on that roof, the police or Secret Service or whoever they were, who were supposed to be on the roof that the shooter ended up on top of, were actually inside that building, most likely hiding from the heat.
Show it. I wish they'd spin their cameras and show it because nobody would believe it. Accept the Republican nomination for president. Right? And we're going to get a good senator. I'll tell you, you have a real stiff right now in office. He's a stiff. McCormick. We got to get McCormick. Press McCormick.
Fuck yeah!
He's a good man, too. He's a valiant fighter. He's a great, great gentleman. So we're going to bring him up can we bring him up for a couple of minutes later?
Yeah.
All right. You get ready, McCormick. You get ready. I'll get you up here. The world will see a vibrant Republican Party that is bigger, stronger, more confident, and more united than ever before. And that's what we are. We're the most united party now. I'm watching the fake news go crazy because they're saying, the Republican Party has not been united since Ronald Reagan like it is right now. And they said there's never been anything like it. They've never seen a movement like this. Make America great again. You know, Joe Biden talks about we have to stop MAGA. MAGA means make America great again, Joe. That's all we want to do. If he was doing the job.
All right, so here's the first sign that somebody in the Secret Service has noticed there's something fishy going on that rooftop.
I wouldn't even be doing this. I'd be at some beautiful place with a gorgeous ocean, the Mediterranean, the Atlantic, maybe the Pacific. Thank you.
Thank you, Trump. Thank you, Trump. Thank you, Trump. Thank you, Trump. Thank you, Trump.
Instead, I'm here with you fighting like hell to get a senator elected and to make sure we take back the White House, because if we do, we're going to make America better than ever before. We're going to make it. And it's not easy because we have millions and millions of people in our country that shouldn't be here. Dangerous people, criminals. We have criminals. We have drug dealers. We have people that should not be here. Teleprompters are so damn boring. I try and explain that. Oh, there's a, wow. You guys are doing it. Right, they're getting better with time. My guys, take a look at that chart. Take a look at the arrow on the bottom. See the big red arrow. Right? So that's when I left office. That was the lowest point, and that comes right from the government services, comes right out of Border Patrol. Take a look at that. So that arrow is the lowest amount of illegal immigration ever in recorded history into our country. And then the worst president in the history of our country took over. And look what happened to our country. Probably 20 million people. And you know, that's a little bit old, that chart. That chart's a couple of months old. And
since the shooting, news has come out that the various agencies involved in security for this event, everyone from Secret Service to local police, were aware of this shooter at least a half hour prior to the shooting. Some say even hours prior to the shooting. They spotted this guy. They flagged him as a suspicious person. They took pictures of him. They saw him looking through a rangefinder at the stage. Pretty shady shit, and they still let this happen. Not to mention, people at the rally saw this guy on the roof up to 2 minutes prior to the shooting and tried to alert Secret Service or police to no avail. They still let this happen. I mean, look at this footage. You can see they weren't even in position to try to defend Trump until the very last seconds before the shooting. Just inexcusable.
If you want to really see something that's sad, take a look at what happened.
Fuck! Holy fucking shit, they're shooting.
Good. Let's just hide behind them.
People started running. Some are running, some aren't. I'm halfway running. These guys aren't scared.
USA!
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 USA! They just told everybody to get out. They're ushering everybody out. Secret Service, the police, they're fucking everywhere.
That's crazy.
Hey, you wanna hear some messed up shit?
You with me, bro?
Yeah.
Officer, it's a heart attack. I'm activating the fucking rounds right now.
But there was blood coming from the side of his head. There was a patch of blood I saw coming from the side of his head. What I think is the most likely action of what happened is Trump is older, so he heard what was going on and instinctively went down like
that. Yeah.
And because he's older, he's going up really fast.
I'll give you that.
Yeah, they got the shoe.
Hey, come on!
I got him.
It's not necessary. I'm sorry. This is my farm show. That's not necessary. Go over there. Come over here. You're not tearing down my farm show.
That's right. That's right,
brother. You tell him.
Tell him, brother.
Get your ass around the back.
Beat channel. $10.
Oh, he died. No, Trump's not. Trump's
no, not Trump.
The other one,
he's
dead.
He's dead.
People are understandably disappointed, hearing a lot of fuck Joe Biden chants, hearing a lot of just nasty, nasty things. People are not happy about this. I've asked several people on the way out of here for an interview, and I've been promptly told to fuck off. People are not in the mood, man. It is a palpable sense of anger and confusion and fear. This is definitely the wildest shit I've ever seen. These people came from God knows where, all over the place. I came 4.5 hours from Baltimore, and now, about less than 10 minutes into it, maybe even like 5 minutes into it, game over, go home, get out. Cops, Secret Service running around screaming, get the fuck out of here, go, go, go. And party's over. Now all these people who are walking to their cars are gonna be trapped here for quite a while. It's probably gonna take hours and hours to get out of this lot. Lucky for me, I picked the wrong lot and I'm way down the street, so I might not have as big of a problem. But here in this free lot, these people are fucked. My phone is blowing up. My friend from North Carolina just called me wanting to know what the fuck was going on. From what I'm hearing, you know, I saw an ambulance go by. They say they got the shooter. Maybe the shooter was in the ambulance. People say, you know, other people said the ambulance was empty. Some people said they saw blood on Trump's head. And I don't know what to believe. I don't know what's the fucking truth. I'm sure we'll hear about it on the news. We'll get whatever official version of what happened that they feel like putting out there. But yeah, wild times here at the Trump rally. My first ever Trump rally, and I picked a good one because what an event. What an event. But show's over, time to go home. These guys are not getting out of here anytime soon. All right, well, I guess that's it for the video, guys. Sorry it was so short. I was planning on making a longer one, but shit happens, you know?